Please introduce yourself.
My name is Moshe Zohar. I'm a faculty member at the Shamoon College of Engineering in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering.
Why has the Shamoon College of Engineering decided to participate in the iPEN project?
The field of nanotechnology is evolving, and as a college that wishes to continue being a leader, we must be aware of the market demands and the direction of scientific and technological developments. In addition, the college's vision ties in with those of the iPEN program, which include enhancing the teaching abilities of the academics in nano-education and teaching methods based on developing the students' soft skills.
How will you take advantage of iPEN's outcomes?
We plan on integrating the modules we built into several departments that integrates different nanotechnology courses into their curriculum and are interested in expanding the number of offered courses. Moreover, the iPEN program will enhance the teaching abilities of the academics in nano-education, and it will provide the most requested soft skills, which are especially important in multidisciplinary fields such as nanotechnology. Equipping our young scientists with the most requested technical and soft skills will enhance their future employability and research capability.
Please explain the connection between photonics and nanotechnology, and please tell me how iPEN addresses some of the challenges we face today.
Nanotechnology includes several aspects of photonics, the two most prominent of which are the use of photonics in nanofabrication and the implication of nanofabricated materials for photonic devices and systems. About 40 models will be built to enable students to be trained both theoretically and in terms of lab work skills, with an emphasis on photonic equipment. The modules will be built according to a survey conducted in relevant population, industry and academia, so as to understand the current difficulties and the knowledge required for graduates to be capable of bridging current deficits.
Why is it important to develop soft skills?
Soft skills are personal attributes that can affect relationship and interactions. Soft skills are becoming the hard skills of today's workforce. It is not enough to be highly trained in technical skills. All career requires at least some soft skills to make the hard skills valuable. Teamwork, leadership, and communication are the underpinning of soft skills developments. Since each one is an essential element for organizational and personal success, developing these skills is very important.
Please tell me why good teaching is important.
Teachers with good communication skills who use both verbal and non-verbal communication help students understand what is expected of them and help build their confidence.